Hello again, everyone. We are back at the What's What studios to discuss matters, how to work them, and why they are important to understand. Sorry about that. What I was saying is we are talking about electricity meters. But like parking meters, electricity meters have their own set of rules and regulations to keep things fair. And when it comes to electricity, you don't want to pay the fee. But before we get started, don't forget to like and subscribe below. When some folks realize I am an electrical engineer, one of the first things they ask is how can I tamper with my electricity meter to reduce my energy bill? My answer to them is you cannot, because firstly, it isn't fair to your neighbors or providers. Secondly, electrical meters are designed to prevent hacking. They are not easily tampered with. Lastly, it will always be more difficult to cheat than play it fair. Or else...
Not again, Frédéric.
All right. Respect. Sound persons. I guess they got rules too. But why don't we get into electricity meters in a little more detail? Measuring electricity is a real task for network operators, and it strategically provides payment plans for a vital service. And I'm sure you have seen your meters at home. But high voltage consumers in the electricity industry and other communities operate simultaneously as well. With each electricity meter, there is no trivial device to count the number of electrons that supply our usage. Instead, we take the legal unit of energy, a joule, and the watt, the unit of power that corresponds to an energy flow of 1 joule per second. From there, we make a representation of units used for electricity consumption, kilowatt hour, as 1 kilowatt hour is equivalent to 3.6 thousand joules. To put these measurements into perspective, we'll look at three main types of electricity meters that have been used over the last decade and examine how they count electricity use. There was a time, hundreds of years ago, when consumers were billed monthly according to the number of lamps they had at home. Imagine that, counting all the lights in your house, then paying a bill accordingly. Would you try to hide them? No, you would count those lamps, all of them. But by 1880, there was an increasing number of commercial electrical use. So there came a need for the electromechanical meter. The birth of the new device is based on electromagnetism, that is the capability to induce a current from a primary alternating current. A moving disc, usually made of aluminum, is mounted on a rotating shaft, which drives a counting mechanism with gears. Alongside it, two electromagnets are arranged on its periphery with parallel axes. The first is traversed by the current flowing through a phase wire, and the second by a current proportional to the supply voltage. Now remember that power equals current times voltage. So this disc is subjected to both alternating magnetic fields directly perpendicularly to the field itself. The field then induces eddy currents to the disc, which in turn generates a magnetic field. The actual torque that determines the rotation of the disc is proportional to the product of the current and the voltage. In practice, the disc passes between the poles of a magnet that is also arranged at its periphery. And this magnet produces another torque that works to adjust the meter. So we have our first device to monitor electricity. But of course, that was just the beginning. Electric meters first came into use during the 90s, over a century after the electromechanical meter. And like many gadgets of this period, it was much more advanced, using a digital display to replace the moving disc and gear wheels with simple and easy to read digits. but the electronic meter only functions according to the Hall effect, where a current flows through its material in the magnetic field and generates perpendicular voltage. Sensors then gauge the change in the field and provide a measurement. It is this Hall effect sensor which surrounds the U-shaped conductor inside the meter that generates a voltage mirroring the outgoing current. With it, the consumption of electricity is calculated according to the kilowatt hour displayed on the digital machine. So basically, the electricity supplied by the grid enters the first branch of the meter before entering the home of the domestic user. In doing so, it provides the quantity of electricity usage in real time. Thus, in the 90s, we had a more adequate monitoring system than before. A bit complex, I know, but sometimes smarter technology brings simpler methodology. And this brings us to the latest and greatest of electricity meters, the smart meter. Smart meters are able to communicate with the grid system, read usage, and switch on and off remotely. This remote control operation saves the cost of a human meter reader and prevents possible errors. Thus, it is no longer necessary to make appointments with utility personnel. Wait, are robots going to take my job?
Stick to the lines, Frédéric.
Right, my lines, no personality. Got it. With the new connection of a subscriber, electricity can be available in just a few hours, where previously it took days. Most systems can be turned on remotely with a simple call to the utility offices, like, for example, to change your power limits. And bills, they are calculated for more accurate consumptions, not estimations between visits of those utility guys. New data allows for precise pricing and detailed invoicing, so we know exactly what we are paying for. Smart meters also help the user to be constantly aware of their consumption. In addition, households equipped with photovoltaic modules, electricity production installation, or positive energy configuration are informed of their variation in generated energy flow. There is even an app that allows smartphone users to check consumption peaks. That way, they can change their behavior and choose to consume energy when it's more affordable. I guess I don't need those anymore. On the lines, right? From a utility provider point of view, the smart meter helps to detect grid incidents early on and from a distance. Faster diagnosis means faster intervention. Duration of power cuts are decreased, and let's say if, for example, a power surge is detected, the smart meter will cut off power supply to avoid possible damage to electrical devices in your home. Lastly, new tariff offers can be adapted to the need of consumption habits, enabling users to save, better manage load peaks, and avoid power cuts. In all, smart meters are a key tool to ensure the continuous stability of electricity networks. They help to manage intermittency of electricity production from renewable resources, and in the future, will facilitate further integration of decarbonized energy into the grid. Oh, and smart meters are really, really good at detecting fraud. Let's do a quick recap to wrap things up. Before electricity meters, there was no adequate way to measure electricity usage. There are three main types of electricity meters. The first, the electromechanical meter, came into use in 1880. The more advanced electronic meter was introduced in the 90s. But smart meters are the most efficient of the group. Smart meters use technology to provide ideal usage, cut costs, prevent grid malfunctions, and protect users. For over two centuries, historical data has helped us to improve the optimization of electricity management on different levels: maintenance, monitoring, and development. And with the better knowledge of electrical distribution, utilities will continue to improve. Any of you want to join our electricity community and help to serve our future? Drop a comment below and let's start brainstorming. We are all in this together after all. This is Frédéric, tuning out.